Hi everyone, how are you today? I hope that you all had a wonderful Thanksgiving with your family. Welcome back. And if you are new here, welcome to my channel, where you can learn the real world coding experience. And this is Huang, the coding expert. If you want to pass the CBC exam, COC exam, CCSP, or any outpatient coding exam to start your coding career, or if you are already holding a coding credential, working in the field, and want to learn more in order to advance your coding profession, then you are in the right place. I believe that you are here today because you have been watching my CBC exam prep video series and would like to learn more in order to prepare for the exam. Did you notice that in the comment section below each video, many people have passed the CBC exam recently by using my tips and strategy and kind enough to share the good news with us, and also let you know that it's not as difficult as you imagine, so you can do it. The question is whether or not you are willing to learn and stay on the course persistently. For those of you who are waiting to take this exam, please be patient. Continue watching my videos, taking notes, typing your books, highlighting your code, reading the coding guidelines, then sooner or later, your time will shine as well. Slowly but surely, you are getting there. Remember, what you learn from my videos is not just for this exam, but also for your own knowledge when you are going out there and working in the real world of coding. Today's topic is how to pass the CBC exam guarantee in 2020 by sitting hands-on practice continue so that you have a chance to apply what you learn into tackling question in case study. So without further ado, let's get started. What you need from my videos from now on are an IC10CM book, a CBT manual book, a HCPC level 2 book, notepads, highlighters, pens and pencil, and a quiet place that you can focus and study. And last but not least is your positive mental attitude. What is the most important element in addition to my tips and strategy that will help you to pass the exam successfully? Also, just a friendly suggestion that if you have any question for me, when you type it in the comment section below, please give me a reference. For example, the case number or which minute of the video so that I know exactly what you refer to and I don't have to watch the entire video to search for your code. Alright, I'm ready for a case study. Are you? Let's do it. Before we tackle case studies, I want to go over the homework that I asked you to do it yourself from the previous video, CBC Exam Prep Hands-on Practice Part 15. Follow my tips and strategy. B and D have the same code, 55700, so they are in the same group. A and C had the different codes, 55705 and 55706, so they are in separate groups. Now you know there are three codes that you need to look up in your CBT book, 55705, 55700, and 55706. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CBT book and hear what you find. 55700, biopsy, prostate, needle or punch, single or multiple, any approach. 55705, this is an indented code, so it includes all information from the code above, 55700, which is the parent code, except this is for incisional, any approach. 55706, biopsies, prostate, needle, transperineal, stereotactic, template guided, saturation sampling, including imaging guidance. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the key difference between each CBT code, and when you're done highlighting, you should know what your focus should be when you read the biopsy report, which is to find out how the prostate biopsy was performed by the needle, by incisional approach, or it is done through perineum. Let's find out. post-operative diagnosis, elevated PSA, procedure, needle biopsy prostate. Operation, after the patient was placed in the lateral decubitus position, 5 needle biopsies were obtained from each prostate lobe under ultrasound guidance. No suspicious areas were noted on the ultrasound evaluation of the prostate, which demonstrated a prostate the size of approximately 70 grams. Patient tolerated the procedure well. What code or codes do you assign for this surgical procedure? You already know the difference between each CPT code and also highlighted the key elements in the procedure report. I'll give you 30 seconds to let me know what should be the correct answer for this case. Your time starts now. If you pick D, congratulations. I'm pretty sure that you did your homework. Good for you. Based on the procedure report, 5 needle biopsy were obtained from each prostate lobe under ultrasound guidance. So, 55700 biopsy prostate needle upon single or multiple any approach is the correct code to you for 5 needle prostate biopsy. 55705 is not the right code to use, because there is no incision made in the procedure report. 55706 is also not the right code to use because it had to be done to perineal approach, and it's not in this case. From here, we can eliminate A and C. B and D still remain, and the only difference between these two answers is B has and C doesn't have it. So let's look up this code in your CBT book and find out what it is for. Please pause video and do it now. Assuming you already did and hear what you find. 10021, 5 needle aspiration without imaging guidance. This code is also called FNA, and this is good to use for skin and subcutaneous lesion needle aspiration, so it does not apply in this case when we already have a specific code for the prostate needle biopsy. Having said that, the correct answer for this case is D, 55700 for prostate needle biopsy and 76942 for the ultrasound guidance. I hope that you did the homework and you all got it right. Let's move on to the next case. Case number 1. Follow my tips and strategy. B and C have the same code, 52648. So they are in the same group. A and D have the different codes, 52647 and 52649. So they are in separate groups. Now you know there are 3 codes that you need to look up in your CBT book, 52647, 52648, and 52649. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CBT book and hear what you got. 52647, laser coagulation of prostate, including control of pulse of bleeding, complete vasectomy, mioartectomy, sphincterurethroscopy, ureteral calibration, and or dilation, and internal ureterotomy are included if performed. 52648, laser vaporization of prostate, including control of pulse of bleeding, complete vasectomy, mioartectomy, sphincterurethroscopy, ureteral calibration, and or dilation, and internal ureterotomy are included if performed. And 52649, laser enucleation of prostate, including control of pulse of bleeding, complete facetomy, myotomy, schistourethroscopy, ureter calibration, and or dilation, and internal ureterotomy are included if performed. Follow my tip and strategy. You highlight the main difference between each cervical, and this step is very important. If you highlight them correctly, it means that you should know what your focus should be when you read the procedure report. Let's find out. A 60-year-old male with suspicious lesion of the prostate undergoes contact laser, vaporization, and resection of the prostate trained ureter approach. The surgeon also performs a diagnostic schistourethroscopy and ureter calibration in the same session, called the procedure. You already know the difference between each cervical and also highlighted the key elements in the procedure report. I'll give you 30 seconds to let me know what should be the correct answer for this case. Your time starts now. If you pick B, congratulations, you are really improving. Based on the procedure report, a contact laser vaporization and resection of the prostate was performed, so there is only one code that applies, which is 5264A, laser vaporization of prostate, including control post op bleeding completed. From here, we can eliminate A and D. B and C still remain. And the only difference between these two answers is C's had 52000, which B doesn't have. So all you have to do next is to look up this code in your CBT book and find out what it is. Please pause video and do it now. Assuming you already did and hear what you got. 52000, schistourethroscopy, separate procedure. Based on CBT 52648 description, this code already includes a diagnostic schistourethroscopy and ureter calibration, so you do not need to assign 5200 as an additional code. If you did, then it would be considered unbundling, so please keep this in mind. That said, the correct answer for this case is B, 52648. Let's move on to the next case. Case number 2. This case is very straightforward. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 11470, 11450, 11451, and 11462. So all you have to do now is open your CBT book and look them up. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your book and hear what you got. 11450, excision of skin and subcutaneous tissue for hidradenitis axillary with simple or intermediate repair. 11451, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the code above, 11450, which is the parent code, except this is done with a complex repair. 11462, excision of skin and subcutaneous tissue for hidradenitis inguinal with simple or intermediate repair. And 11470, excision of skin and subcutaneous tissue for hidradenitis perianal, perineal, or umbilical with simple or intermediate repair. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the main difference between each cervical, and when you're done, you should have an idea what your focus should be when you read the procedure report. Let's find out. Post-operative diagnosis: left axillary hidradenitis. Operation: excision of hidradenitis. The patient is a 60-year-old female with chronically infected left axillary hidradenitis. With the patient in supine position and under general anesthesia, the left axilla was prepped and draped in the usual sterile fashion. An elliptical skin incision was made in the axilla to excise most of the hidradenitic tract. The incision was carried out to subcutaneous tissue. The underlying subcutaneous tissue was excised. The subcutaneous tissue was closed in intermediate layer. The patient tolerated the procedure well. What is the critical for this procedure? You already highlight the main difference between each cervical and also highlight the key element in the procedure report. I'll give you 30 seconds to let me know what should be the correct answer for this case. Your time starts now. If you pick B, 11450, congratulations, you figured that out fast. Based on the procedure report, an incision of hidradenitis in the axilla was performed, and the report also indicated the wound was low in layer or intermediate repair. And if you look closely at all the codes listed below, code 4, an incision of hidradenitis is classified based on the anatomical site and the type of repairs. CPT 11450, excision of skin and subcutaneous tissue for hidradenitis axilla with symbol or intermediate repair is the correct code to you. That said, the correct answer for this case is B, 11450. I hope you got it right. Let's move on to the next case. Case number 3. This case is very straightforward. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 36561, 36590, 36589, and 36581. So all you have to do now is open your CBT book and look them up. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CBT book and hear what you got. 36561, insertion of tunnel centrally inserted central venous access device with subcutaneous port aged 5 years or older. 36581, replacement complete of a tunnel centrally inserted central venous catheter without subcutaneous port or pump to same venous access. 36589, removal of tunnel central venous catheter without subcutaneous port or pump. And 36590, removal of tunnel central venous access device with subcutaneous port or pump, central or peripheral insertion. Follow my tip and strategy. You highlight the main difference between each cervical, and when you're done highlighting, you should know what your focus should be when you read the procedure report. In this case, your job is to find out if a central venous catheter is inserted, replaced, removed, with or without port. Before I start reading the procedure report, I want you to know the anatomy of the central venous catheter. This is your port cap, and in this case, it's a mini port. In medicine, a port is more medical appearance that is installed beneath the skin. Its name, portcap, indicates it considers two parts, the portal and the catheter. This is a portal, and it is attached to a catheter, a thin flexible tube that is thread into the large vein above the right side of the head called superior vena cava. There are two types of central venous catheter, tunnel and non-tunnel. Tunnel central venous catheters are placed under the skin and mean to be used for a longer duration of time. For example, people on chemotherapy for cancer, or long-term antibiotics to fight infection, or people on kidney dialysis, etc. Non-tunnel catheters are designed to be temporary and may be put into a large vein near your neck, chest, or groin. And this is a PICC line, peripherally inserted central catheter. You can see difference between the PICC line. It doesn't have a portal like a portal cap. Also, the catheter is placed through a vein in your arm. That's why it's called peripheral inserted. Peripheral means away from the center. It refers to area away from the center of the body or body part. I want you to notice so that when you read the procedure report, you should know exactly which central venous device that you are dealing with. Let's go back to our case study and read the procedure report. Operation: removal of left subclavian medial port. Indication: the patient is a 70-year-old woman. She had medial port placed for chemotherapy for colon cancer, and it is no longer being used. The patient was placed in the supine position. The left chest was prepped with bentonite and draped in sterile fashion. 1% lidocaine with epinephrine was infiltrated, and an incision was made in the old scar and the section carried down to the port. The capsule around the port was inside and the port was removed. The wound was then closed with an 4-0 Vicryl on the subcutaneous layer and 4-0 Vicryl subcuticular stick on the skin. The patient tolerate this well. What is the procedure code? You already know the difference between each subcutical, and also highlight the key element in the procedure report. I'll give you 30 seconds to let me know what should be the correct answer for this case. Your time starts now. If you pick B, congratulations, you are learning fast. Based on the procedure report, a mediport or portal cap is removed. So there are only two codes that you have to look at for the removal, which are 36589 and 36590. However, the procedure report clearly indicates that the incision was made in the old scar and the section carried out to the port. The capsule around the port was inside and the port was removed. So, 36590 removal of tunnel central venous access device with subcutaneous port or pump is the correct code to you in this case. Having said that, the correct answer for this case is B, 36590. Just a friendly reminder that if you have enjoyed what you have learned so far and appreciate my time spent for this video, then you could please pause the video, click the like, subscribe, and share buttons below now to support my channel. That'd be great. Again, you are the reason why I continue working hard on these videos. It's very time consuming, but it's free, so I don't think it's too much to ask for your support. Thank you so much, and we should move on to the next case. Case number 4. This is a short case with a few sentences, so I recommend that you read it first instead of proof the code from the answer that I normally do. A patient presents with nausea and vomiting after taking a course of amoxicillin, penicillin. That's what prescribed by her primary care physician. She followed the instruction for the proper use of medication. What ICD-10-CM code should be used for this visit? If you watch all my videos and take note, then you should know how to handle this case. I'll give you 30 seconds to let me know what would be the correct answer for this case. Your time starts now. If you pick C, congratulations, good for you. Based on what I just highlighted, and if you watch my videos about echo effect versus Bosonian, then you should know this is clearly an echo effect case when the patient takes a medication prescribed by her physician and then develops nausea and vomiting. According to the ICD-10-CM coding guidelines, when coding an echo effect of the drug that has been correctly prescribed and properly administered, you have to assign first the appropriate code for the nature of the echo effect, which is nausea and vomiting in this case, followed by the T code of the drug, category T36 to T50. Having said that, you need to have two codes in this case, and the first code listed must be for nausea and vomiting, followed by the T code for the drug. Looking at the answer A, B, C, and D, only C has the code followed by a T code for a drug. The rest of them do not apply. So C must be the correct answer. I guarantee you, if you look up I-11.2, it must be for nausea and vomiting. Now you know, if you watch all my videos and take note, and also read the coding guidelines, then you should know how to handle this case in a matter of seconds without even look up codes in your book. But for your reference, please pause the video and look up these two codes, I-11.2 and T36.0X5A. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already did and hear what you got. I-11.2, nausea and vomiting unspecified, and T36.0X5A, echo effect of penicillin initial encounter, that have been verified for your reference. So again, the correct answer for this case is C, I-11.2 and T36.0X5A. I hope that you follow me okay. Let's tackle the last case. Case number 5. This is also a short case with a few sentences, so I read it first. A teenage girl fall from the horse she riding and injure her left wrist. X-ray reveal a break up lower end of the radius with backward displacement. The radiology documents a left coast fracture. What ICD-10-CM codes would be assigned? Based on what I just read and highlighted, you can tell this is an injury-related condition. And if you watch all my previous video and take note, then you should remember what I said before, that any injury codes which start with letter S and Bosonian codes which start with letter T, sign and symptom code which start with letter R. Conditions related to injury are fracture, sprain, strain, laceration, abrasion, burns, dislocation, contusion, etc. In this case, it's a fracture, so the code must start with letter S. From here, we can eliminate B. Follow my tips and strategy. C and D have the same code, S52.532A, so they are in the same group. A has different code, S52.531A, so it is in separate group. Now you know there are two codes that you need to look up in your ICD-10-CM book, S52.531A and S52.532A. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already did and hear what you got, S52.531A cause fracture of right radius initial encounter. And SV2.532A cause fracture of left radius initial encounter. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the main difference between two codes, and since you already highlighted the key element in the report, I'll give you 30 seconds to let me know what should be the correct answer for this case. Please pause the video if you need more time. The time starts now. If you pick C, congratulations, you should be ready for the exam. Based on the report, the radiologic document a left cause fracture, so S52-532A is the correct diagnosis code to you in this case. From here, we can eliminate A. C and D still remain, and the only difference between the two answers is C had VA0.010A. And D has VAD.11XA. So all you have to do next is look up these two codes in your ICD-10 book. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already did and here what you got. VAD.010A, animal rider injured by fall from or being towed from horse in non-collision accident, initial encounter. And VAD.11XA, animal rider injured in collision with pedestrian or animal initial encounter. Based on the report, the patient falls from a horse and there is no collision with pedestrian or animal. So VA0.010A is the correct accidental cause code to you. Having said that, the correct answer for this case is C, S52.532A. And VAD.010A. That is all for today. Thank you so much for watching, for liking and sharing this video. If you find this video helpful, informative and easy to learn with this format, or if you have any suggestion, then please leave me a comment below just to let me know. I really appreciate it. Also, the more comments that you leave for me, the better chance for my videos will be reviewed by other people, so please continue to do so. Until next time, have a great day.